Our final speaker for the first half is a laser artist and a recontextualizer of antique beer kegs. Please welcome Mike Gould.
All right. Well, once upon a time, I was cruising on eBay and I saw this wonderful antique beer keg. I thought to myself, that would look really cool with lasers shooting out the bunghole. So I bought it for $40 and it sat in my garage for a couple of years while I raised enough money to realize my dream. So fast forward to 2013, I was able to make a few bucks doing a laser show in the Michigan Stadium. So I bought a bunch of parts and hired this nice young man to take a plasma torch to the beer keg and cut it in half. Now this is the seldom seen innards of a half keg of beer. There's lines here that show where the base plate is going to go. This is going to get filled in for the support stuff. And for the first time I realized I'm putting 10 pounds of stuff in a 5-pound keg, so I better design it ahead of time. So I whipped out McDraft and I drew this diagram that I hoped I could fit into the beer keg. And so I did. I made a first prototype of the base plate out of plywood and put the stuff on it to see how it would all fit and arrange it and get it exactly right. Horsed it in and out of the keg several times. And then I took that plywood piece to a metalworker shop who cut it in this particular shape, took it back to my office, drilled and tapped all the holes, and that's what supports all the stuff. Now this is the top of the base plate. It has all the power and heat regulating stuff. We have a bunch of fins and fans that dissipate the heat that the lasers provide. Now the bottom part, which is shown upside down here, is where the lasers live. These are aluminum drawer handles that I bought to make it a little bit easier to horse the thing in and out as I'm doing fittings. Also, they supported the cables once everything was done. This is the blue laser I built. It has two-watt laser diodes that are combined through a bunch of optics and then are shaped with some additional prisms. Now, in order to get everything aligned properly, I set up a couple of mirrors in my office and shot the beam from one side to the other so I'd get about 50 feet of throw so I could get the beam as tight as possible at that distance. Now this is my buddy Bob Snyder working on the red laser. He had four diodes to wrestle into place. And this is, I should say, dangerous as hell. Don't try this at home. These are pretty powerful. Here I am lining up the first time with the blue laser, goes to a mirror which goes down here, hits that mirror, goes here. A green laser goes here, they get combined by the optics. This is a laser power meter that I use to measure how much energy I'm losing every time it goes through a piece of optics. Now it takes a village, and this is villager Wayne Gillis. He and I have been working together for years. He built the power supply for the device, and he also did some of the internal wiring. There I am making last-minute tweaks. You can see the wires coming down being supported by those drawer pulls. The lid contains the electronics for it, and this is sort of what my shop looks like. Tremble before the awesomeness that is Brewster. This is the business end, including the highly sophisticated shutter mechanism that I... But it's federally mandated. The government says any laser is going to have a shutter. So this shows it at full blast. There's the blue laser. It bounces here, goes that way. The green laser goes like that. The red laser comes down, goes like that, goes there, there, there. This is called a galvo. And this is the Brewster in its first incarnation, the first time we used it. This was April of this year. Here we see... some of our crew, A-Ray, and my art thing, anyway. Then we went to the Henry Ford Museum for Maker Faire. And we projected in the aviation area, and we hung up a big screen and projected various logos and whatnot. Now here I am, and there is Brewster doing what he does best. Now, he's standing next to a previous projector I built into a vacuum cleaner. We have some passers-by and a paparazzi wearing a familiar T-shirt. Okay, so this is the Makey, the logo for Maker Faire. And at this point, you're probably wondering, why would an otherwise sane individual want to put a laser projector in a beer keg? Well, one, because I like to. Two, because I can. And three, as an artist, I must. Thank you very much.
Yes, so thanks, Mike. Before we take a break, what do you say we fire that thing up?
Fire it up!
We're going to have a brief intermission for about 15 minutes, so we'll get started again around 8:20. I think you might see some acro yoga out in the atrium. Not really sure, but keep your eyes open for that, and we'll see you at 8:20. Thanks.
Right underneath, so if you don't be able to see it, you'll be able to see it.